Hi, I'm Victor Cohen. This is the MCAT for Victory Anki course, and today we are going to talk about how the Anki algorithm will help you memorize all the content on the MCAT. We will be going over the Leitner system, the effectiveness of spaced repetition, and the importance of active recall. Generally, when people study from flashcards, they review all the cards almost every single day. This is manageable when studying a few flashcards for a short period of time, but the MCAT for Victory Anki deck includes thousands of flashcards. If you were to get all the cards from the MCAT for Victory Anki deck and stack them on top of each other, the deck would end up being about 2.5 feet tall. This is far too much information to review every single day. Additionally, you have other obligations while studying for the MCAT, like watching the MCAT for Victory videos, reading the textbook, and answering questions. You will also want to get 8 hours of sleep at night, and you should be giving yourself some time to take care of your physical and mental health. This means all your time cannot be spent reviewing flashcards. So, to memorize everything on the MCAT, you need a smart and effective system. Fortunately, Anki has an amazing algorithm that spaces out all the facts in order to make studying for the MCAT much more manageable. So, how exactly does Anki help you memorize everything? Well, it uses something called the Leitner system, and here's how it works. First, you start with all your cards together in one deck. This deck includes all of the cards that you have yet to see. These cards are called new. Once you see a card, it moves on to a different deck, based on the interval at which you will see that card again. If you get the card wrong, you will place the card in the second deck. This deck includes all the cards that you will review again in 5 minutes. On the other hand, if you get the card right, it goes to the third deck. The third deck includes all the cards that you will review again in 30 minutes. After going through a few cards, you will have some cards in the 5-minute deck and others in the 30-minute deck. After 30 minutes of studying passes, you will begin to see cards from the 30-minute deck. When you pick them up, you again decide whether or not you got the card right or wrong. If you got the card wrong, it moves back to the 5-minute deck. But if you got the card right, it moves on to the 1-day deck. All the cards on the 1-day deck will not be reviewed again until tomorrow. On the next day of your studying, once the cards graduate from the 1-day deck, they'll move on to the 3-day deck. After the 3-day deck, they will go on to the 5-day deck, and so on. However, if at any point you get the card wrong, the card goes all the way back to the beginning into the 3-minute deck. Then you restart the system back from the beginning for that card. The reason the Leitner system works so well is because it uses spaced repetition. In the 1880s, a psychologist named Hermann Ebbinghaus ran a study on himself where he wanted to see how long it would take for him to forget 100 vocabulary words. He realized that he recalled fewer words the more time that passed between studying the words and being quizzed on the words. He was then able to make an equation for what he would call the forgetting curve. He realized the rate at which he would forget the words was relatively consistent. Later, researchers studied the best ways to fight the forgetting curve. They found that the best way to remember information was to review it right before it would have been forgotten. The harder it is to remember the answer, the longer the person would retain that information after recalling it. Given this information, Anki uses the Leitner system with an additional algorithm they call ease factor. As you study, different cards have different levels of difficulty. While you may find all the cards for mitosis and meiosis easy, another student may think those cards are incredibly difficult. On the other hand, you may think that the psychological disorders are very difficult to remember, while another student may find them relatively easy. So, the Anki algorithm learns which cards you find difficult and which cards you find easy, and changes their code to reflect that. With a larger ease factor, easier cards will have a longer interval between reviews. This means that you will not see those cards as often. Meanwhile, harder cards will have a lower ease factor, meaning you will see those cards more often. The way Anki decides how easy or how difficult a card is will be based on how you respond. In order to filter the cards into different decks, Anki will ask you to evaluate your answer. You will have 4 choices. You will select wrong if you were not able to guess the correct answer. You will select hard if you felt like you were guessing and happened to get the answer right. Good if you answered correctly. And easy if you thought you could answer that flashcard correct in your sleep. If you get the card wrong, or if you say that the card was hard, Anki will lower the ease factor, meaning you will see the card more often. If you say that the card was good, Anki will not change the ease factor. Finally, if you say that you thought the card was easy, Anki will raise the ease factor, meaning you will see the card less often. The great thing about Anki is that it does all the organizing for you. Your job is to simply answer the flashcards when they are due and state how difficult you thought the card was. Most of the time, you will hopefully answer good. Please do not answer wrong or hard to see the card more often. Only select those choices if you got the card wrong or if you happen to have guessed correctly. Anki will then take care of the ease factor and will properly space the cards out to make sure you see them right before you're about to forget them. Anki is set up so that you will recall correctly around 85% of the cards. It is incredibly important for you to learn the material before you use Anki, because it will significantly improve your efficiency. If you do not properly learn the information before starting the flashcards, the ease factor for all your cards will be very low. This means you will see the cards over and over again, which will be a huge waste of time. If, on the other hand, you learn the information properly before seeing them, you will be better at answering the cards correctly, which will therefore increase their ease factor, meaning you will spend less time reviewing flashcards and more time learning new information or applying that information to questions. In other words, make sure you first watch the respective MCAT for Victory video before going through the new cards. I know Anki can be very intimidating, but it is a marvelous application that is worth learning. The algorithm is extraordinarily effective at helping you learn a large amount of information. There is a good reason why many people choose Anki to learn a new language, and a lot of medical students are using it as their main study tool. Based on research, those who use Anki tend to score better on their board exams for medical school. So, it is worth taking the time to learn how to use the application properly now so that you come into medical school with a huge advantage. Not only that, but Anki will also help you get an incredible MCAT score. Just note that Anki is not magic. It is a tool that will make studying more efficient, but it takes a lot of work and perseverance to use it correctly. The best way to study for the MCAT is by first learning the material by watching videos like those available on the MCAT for Victory course, then reviewing the material to make sure you understand everything properly, then memorizing that material through the use of flashcards like Anki, and finally, answering questions to see how good you are at applying everything you learned. And that's where I'm going to end this episode. In this video, we covered how the Anki algorithm will help you memorize MCAT content. Next episode, we will go over how to download Anki and how to download the MCAT for Victory Anki deck.